That's so retrograde.
Minis.
Anyway, I just think that being aware of how much we consume is just a really important part of this. And composting is a beautiful way to bring that to the surface. And
is there a compost bin for like beginners that, because this is my research moment right now that I've been looking into. Is there one that you can recommend?
So it's called Compost Australia.
Okay.
I love. And the website is composta.com.au. So C-O-M-P-O-S-T-A, composta.com.au. And the reason I so love this, here, I'm going to show you here. This is what it looks like.
Ooh,
and the reason I love
it's pretty.
It's a worm bin in the center.
Okay.
And so it's also small enough. It's small. I mean, it's like the size of where I'm sitting. It's small enough that you can bring this into an apartment. And here, I'll give you context of size.
Oh, great.
So it's really good for, you know, it's a really like inclusive product. And then another company, which mine's not here yet. It arrives tomorrow, but this is the only thing I got for my birthday because I just, I'm not big on receiving gifts because I think that there's just too much in the world that goes to waste. So, handmade things are cool. And then this, and I'm going to show you, this is called Lettuce Grow. Mine arrives tomorrow and it's lettucegrow.com. And you guys are about to lose your minds. So basically, it's a hydroponic system where you can grow up to 36 vegetables by yourself, no help. We're not talking like a 20-foot garden bed. It's a vertical garden, hydroponic. They send you the non-GMO organic seedlings that are, so they're already sprouted. You put them in every 3 weeks, and within 3 weeks, those grow to full maturity. You harvest them, put them in your fridge, and they stay good for probably a month, I'm sure, because I don't know if you guys know this, but when you get stuff from the grocery store, it's already been on its journey for 2 weeks, which is why it wilts so fast, but this will stay good for a month. You're gonna eat your vegetables and immediately replant your seedlings, which they send right to you. I mean, I should really be an ambassador for them. I'm not.
Yeah, the excitement that you have right now, I'm just like, where do I buy?
So look at how beautiful this is.
Oh, wow.
This is like, that's one right there. And this is like your chard, your kale, your, you can grow big things too, like cauliflower, you know, big beefsteak tomatoes, and then there's a whole, look how beautiful. So multi-purpose is a big part of sustainability and we can jump into that too, but versatility and multi-purpose. So everything that I design and create, and I'm bringing that up as a natural segue because I love that these vertical hydroponic vegetable towers are multifunctional in that they make beautiful like foliage and like decorative, like it looks like you have a garden except it's edible. Like what are we, do you guys think about this? What are we doing watering lawns?
Yeah.
Why do we water lawns when we could water things that we could eat?
Yeah.
We could create, I mean, regenerative farming and soil is the only actual, and we can, let's go into this for one quick sec because we were talking about fashion. Yes, yeah. Fashion is like the top one of the top three most polluting industries in the world. Sure. Totally true. But truly the only way to reverse climate change. So we don't want to sustain, right? We want to reverse. And we could take all the cars off the road, all the planes out of the sky, never produce another garment again. And the world is in a really bad place because of the emissions that are already out there, because of the carbon that's already, we've already got so much trapped out there. So we need to reverse, not sustain. And the only thing that's going to do that is sequestering carbon. So what does that? Soil. So regenerative farming is the conversation we really need to be having right now, because once we get into a place where we're actually taking that carbon and pulling it back into the soil, we can reverse climate change immediately. Like I'm not a scientist, but I do read about this a lot, and it's a matter of months or short years, and we'll see huge, huge effects from simple things that we can all do. And one of those is, why the fuck are we watering lawns? we should be growing, we should be creating healthy soil and growing food and having cover crops and pulling that carbon back down into the ground where it belongs. That's what we should be doing. So I'm glad that this whole podcast became about composting and growlettuce.com.
No, that's amazing.
Lettucegrow.com.
Why I love that too is that it's completely doable for us to take into our own hands on a micro level, like with little things like that. Oh, my
that's
God.
That's gorgeous.
They're so okay, cute.
I think I need one of those.
Yeah, so my landlord who I live with, she grows lettuce. She grows like lettuce and kale and like all these vegetables. And the other day I didn't have any lettuce. I'm like grocery store shook and go as few times as possible. And I was like, I really need to like eat a green, but I can't drive down this goddamn mountain again and, you know, put gloves on. So I guess I'll just eat my hands. And she's like, I have lettuce, butter lettuce and kale growing in the garden. So I went down and I just kind of like leaned over into the thing and was picking all the lettuce. And I was like, I felt so cool. I was like, this is the coolest thing. And then I came back, I had to wash it. There was like some worms on it. I was like, I'm a farmer girl. Like this is,
and I felt, but it is cool.
It is really cool.
It makes you feel like you're connected to something. Mm-hmm. And I know that sounds like a big, like hippy dippy thing to say, but it's the truth. You feel so connected to what you're doing and like proud. Tell me you did not feel more proud of that salad when you ate it. You probably snapped a pic.
I thought it was so cool. Yeah. I mean, I personally didn't grow it, so I'm still like a little bit like leaning over the edge into someone else's good deeds. But at the same time, just being a part of it, I'm like, this is doable and this is cool. And it honestly, to me, felt like it tasted better because I knew exactly where it came from.
But by the way, you can give yourself that credit because it has nothing to do with, okay, you didn't grow it. But even if there were a bunch of yous out there who are not growing the lettuce, but actually supporting local farmers or actually going to a farm and learning how something works, it makes you more interested mm-hmm. in that thing. There are mm-hmm. a few local farms around where I am. I mean, I still have to drive like 20 minutes, but there are a few farms nearby that are now adopting that model of like, hey, people come pick your own food and be a part of this. And I know that there are people that drive, you know, from the middle of the city just for the experience
yeah.
of that, you know, to bring their children. I mean, there is a collective call right now to return to nature. This is something that everybody is feeling, mm-hmm. no matter where you are in some capacity. To what degree, obviously, varies, but everybody's also, there.
And to tap into that natural rhythm and that cycle that we've had since the beginning of time, it forms a deeper connection to ourselves and our own relationship to our existence. Like it is a deep, it's simple, but it's a really deep concept that if one byproduct can be a reconnection with that of this whole time, I think that what a beautiful outcome.